was London's first mainline station. Approached through an imposing Doric arch, demolished despite a national outcry in 1961. The Queen officially opened the brand new station in October 1968, although mainline electric trains had been using it since January 1966. Perhaps it's best to pass quickly through the concourse and down the ramp to platform 14, from where the Royal Scot is about to depart, hauled by a Class 87 electric locomotive. Linking London with Glasgow via the West Coast Main Line, the Royal Scot leaves Euston at 10:40 and is scheduled to run non-stop to Preston, covering the 209 miles in 140 minutes. The express was first called the Royal Scot in 1927 and used to depart at 10 o'clock. As far as Rugby, the route followed is that of the London and Birmingham Railway, built by Robert Stephenson and completed in 1838. Emerging from the tunnel, the train passes beneath the former Great Central Main Line into Marylebone. This is Queen's Park, the fourth station out of Euston, which used to have mainline platforms before the Watford New Lines were built. Here, the Bakerloo Tube Line surfaces from Paddington and joins up with the Watford New Lines. We pass under the Great Central Line again. The High Wycombe route, having split at Neasden, now has an hourly service of Chiltern Turbo trains to Birmingham Snow Hill. This is north after the line opened. As the Royal Scot speeds through, there's a brief moment to reflect on the scene of Britain's worst peacetime railway disaster. On the morning of the 8th of October 1952, the Perth to Euston sleeper, for reasons which remain a mystery, ignored signals of danger and hit the rear of a Tring to Euston commuter train, which was busy loading at the mainline platform. Moments later, travelling at 60 miles an hour, a double-headed Euston to Manchester Express ploughed into the wreckage. The final death toll was 122. Most of the casualties were in the local train. Headstone Lane station is served solely by BR services these days, the Bakerloo line terminating at Harrow and Wealdstone and platform buildings, with the single-track branch to St Albans Abbey curving away to the right. A spur onto the main line from the new lines provides a brief section of track electrified on both AC and DC systems, allowing transfer of the dual-voltage Class 313s. The new city of Milton Keynes comes into view, with a remarkable absence of high-rise buildings. Milton Keynes Central opened in 1982, all glass and plastic, with distinctive portholes on the enclosed footbridge. Almost 50 miles from Euston, two of the four outer suburban trains, which run every hour, terminate here with an end-to-end time of 65 minutes. A third train continues to Northampton, with the fourth reaching Birmingham New Street. We pass to the side of Rugby's great barn of a station, opened on July the 3rd, 1885, with a dance for 2,000 people on the huge island platform. Admission sixpence, proceeds to the local hospital. The down Birmingham line forks to the left and the Royal Scot dips under the 1960s flyover, which carries the Up Birmingham. This is where we leave the original main line at Trent Valley Junction. Twin our stone bridge, while we cross the river on a girder bridge. The need for investment in the country's foremost main line. Here, 209 miles from Euston, the Royal Scot makes its first scheduled stop for 1 minute only. Arrival time should be 1 o'clock, but due to a late start from Euston, caused by an unattended baggage incident, and the earlier excursion onto the slow line, we're now running 37 minutes late. For some, this is the end of the journey, while for others, it's only the beginning.